What do you consider beautiful?
Hello, my name is Ferrara Henry, unusual name. I'm from San Francisco, California. I reside right now in Oakland, California, which I love. I currently go by the name of Farrah Fox with two X's.
This is gonna hurt. My name is Ekaterina Valishiva. I'm from Russia, from little city on east part. It's called Khabarovsk. I'm the only child in my family. I had a cat, and you know, we were like really, really good together. Very nice family. I love my parents. What else can I say?
To me, my childhood was, I might get a little teary because I've never had the opportunity to really speak on my life. My father and my mother were heroin users when I was younger, and my mother, she tried to kill me, you know, in the course of her her drug abuse.
I've been modeling for about, I'd say, 8 years. It started absolutely randomly. I didn't want to be a model ever. It's just a friend of mine, he got a new camera and he asked me if I want to try it with him, just to try to do a shoot.
All I remember really is the tragedy. You know, my father, he kicked me out. And he shouldn't have never kicked me out. I wish he would have just been like, you know, I'm gonna chastise me. But he put me out. And when he put me out, I had nowhere to go. It was late at night, it was like 10 at night, San Francisco. And so I was just aimlessly walking, and a guy pulled up. And he was like the neighborhood guy, and he was in a Cadillac. And you know, he was like, wow, a Cadillac, and the long hair, and all that. And he talked to me. I think he used to flirt with me, but they knew I was a little girl. He wasn't a little guy, he was an older guy. He turned me out to prostitution. And back in the day, that was embarrassing. Like, I was a freak. I really did feel like a freak. It was my dirty little secret, and it was just out, you know. But I guess at that time, I wasn't a little girl anymore. I had been exposed to too much.
Well, I don't know. When I was growing up, it's not that I felt beautiful or something. I know a lot of people told me that I'm cute and stuff and I need to do modeling, but I never thought that I can actually do it for real.
It's dangerous for kids to not know that they're not beautiful. It doesn't matter what size, shape, color you are, you know, that's just society's way of saying it. Where are your standards at to say that I'm not beautiful? Where is it in the book that say because my size or my cellulite or, you know, my rose, who wrote that said I wasn't beautiful? Just me being who I am today, that's beautiful. You know what I'm saying? Look at me. You don't have to be like that. You don't have to sit like that. You don't have to hide. That's you. Embrace it. Like, I'm a survivor. And I told myself I was a survivor, and I felt good because I was like, I'm a survivor. Can't nobody touch me, you know?
What happened during the photo shoot was I was able to get to know her and who she is as a person and her history, and I became really infatuated with her and just really love her to death. We started doing some amazing single solo shots that was based around her letting out the pain of the loss of her mother. One of the ways we did that was Rallis had this gel that I had her drink. I would tell her now's the time to let it all out. And we had such a bond where she just literally threw up the pain and it came out in this white gel and all over her. And she's face is beautiful and her body is, you know, all modeled and painted white, and you just kind of put it all together emotionally and you see it. As a photographer, it was was unbelievable watching it go down and her sighing relief afterwards and saying she feels like she's 100 pounds lighter.
The idea was to show one side as the burn face, right? And another was still me, like normal, pretty me. And it was really weird to look at myself in the mirror because like I look at one side, it looks like something that came out from hell, just totally disturbing. And you turn another side, it was like the pretty lady. So it was interesting. It was interesting feeling, like how do you feel about it? Because you know, it's like one side this way, another side is totally different. So it's kind of, I don't know, mixed emotions.
What the idea was with me and Rallis was to find an extremely beautiful girl, as society would consider beautiful, and me too. She's very beautiful. But I wanted to take half of her face and disfigure it. And as you would look to one side, she was society's version of beauty, and to the other side, she's not beautiful, by mainstream media at least. And in my eyes, I saw beauty in both sides.
When I first saw my final picture, I realized that it's actually not who you are outside, but who you are inside more.
When she saw the photos, she was just like, her mouth fell open, and she said, I look so beautiful. And I go, yes, you do.
I love when someone does something with a message, that it's not just a beauty picture, but that has a message under it. Nikki has his eye on everything.
I started really feeling pretty. I didn't feel like slutty, I felt like pretty. I think this was like my highlight. This was the best photo shoot that I ever did. This is something I really, really, really could be proud of. Taking off my clothes and really, really, really be proud of.
Getting that emotion to come out. Like she left like some of her pain at Funny Farm.
So I'm reaching for the stars and reaching for my new dreams.